It's great to be here at CNA's annual conference. Actually, the first time I've been on this side of the microphone. And what a turnout. Last night was a great event. And good to see so many people interested in the future of this industry. And I would like to add my thanks as well to Hitachi and GE Hitachi Canada for sponsoring this session. Right now, I'd like to start things off by asking a favor of you. No, I'm not going to ask you to turn off your cell phones, though you can do that. And I'm not going to ask you to do one of those icebreaker exercises, you know, like hug the person next to you. Although you can do that. Instead, what I want you to do is pay attention to the following three words. T minus 26. That's all. Just three words. T minus 26. It isn't a riddle. It isn't a word game. It's a statement of fact. A fact that signifies, I believe, a major event for our industry, for OPG, for Ontario, and indeed for all of Canada. In just 26 days, on March 21st, public hearings will begin on the environmental assessment for new nuclear units at OPG's Darlington site. And this is the first time such a process has been undertaken for new nuclear in Canada. In effect, new nuclear is on the verge of becoming a reality in Ontario. Now, we're not there yet. We don't have liftoff. But we're definitely moving to the launch pad. And as you may have guessed by now, I'm going to talk today about nuclear new build. I picked this topic because it's timely, and I think it's consistent with the theme of the conference. And frankly, it's the key to our future as an industry. New nuclear is the major growth opportunity on the horizon today. And I believe that statement is true for our industry. It's also true for many other industries involved in infrastructure. I also believe that building of new nuclear reactors, if it is to be successful, must deliver value. Value to Ontario and Canada. Value to our host communities. And good to see many of our host communities represented here today. Thank you for coming. Value to business and to industry. And especially value to the ratepayers and taxpayers who benefit from these capital projects and who also pay for them. Now, I've been talking a lot lately about value. I spoke about it in November to the Association of Power Producers of Ontario in the context of ratepayer frustration over electricity bills and the industry's need to connect with its customers. I talked about it again at the Ontario Energy Network in Toronto last December in the context of nuclear refurbishment and the importance, the critical importance, of delivering projects on time and on budget. My focus on value today is based on the following question. Can we deliver nuclear new build in a way that provides value in the broadest sense of the word? You know, at the end of the day, when the reactors are built, our stakeholders, our customers, ratepayers, the community will want an answer to that question. And we better be able to deliver, because in my view, we won't get a second chance. I believe we can deliver as an industry. And what's more, I believe that OPG occupies perhaps a unique and strong position from which to advance this process. In fact, we're already pursuing several critical factors essential to new build success. First, we're focused on getting all the right approvals and public input completed in a timely manner. Our goal is to fulfill the necessary requirements in an open and transparent way. And we're meeting that goal. In the fall of 2009, we submitted an environmental impact statement and updated license to prepare the site at Darlington. The submission represented more than 3 years of detailed work in and around the Darlington site and included extensive public and community consultation. And the public hearings, as I've said, start on March 21st of this year. They represent the final phase of the environmental review. And what's more, they give us an opportunity to again hear, consider, and respond to public input on our studies and analyses. And we look forward to that opportunity. The other thing, good thing about our progress on the approvals front is that it reduces the chances of delay. Since we almost already completed most of our environmental and site preparation requirements, we can move quickly once the suspended procurement process resumes and regulatory approvals are received. The second area we're focusing on involves getting the right reactor technology. As you know, OPG has conducted a technology-neutral environmental assessment. And we've looked at all the benefits and limitations of the technology options. That said, as the largest nuclear operator in Canada and the largest CANDU owner in the world, we can clearly see the merit in continuing to use CANDU technology. In particular, we can see the merit in building enhanced CANDUs at the Darlington site. This is consistent with the Ontario government's position as stated in its long-term energy plan. The plan also states that new nuclear must be provided at a fair price to ratepayers, which is our position as well. This assumes, of course, the enhanced CANDU satisfies OPG's criteria for value, appropriate risk sharing, and risk mitigation. Now, I realize that others may have their own opinions about what kind of reactor to use. I respect that. But right now, for OPG, the enhanced CANDU is, in our opinion, a good fit. And this is especially true given our long history in operating this technology. The third element for new build success, and I might argue the most important, is people. The new units will need fully trained and experienced operators ready to go. And we have an excellent solution. By about 2020, our Pickering station will reach the end of its operating life. Pickering employs over 2,500 skilled and very experienced nuclear energy professionals. And once the station is placed into safe storage, these employees will be freed up to operate the new units at Darlington. These workers are a tremendous and unique asset. The scenario I've just described assumes that the new units will come online after Pickering is placed into safe storage. So the timing has to be right to take advantage of this large and talented workforce. So we have to plan well. And we believe with careful outage management, we can manage the time frame of winding down Pickering so that it matches the construction schedule of the new units. Our final success factor involves OPG's status as an established and capable nuclear operator. Now, I've been in the nuclear business for more than 30 years, and I've observed many nuclear power plants and companies around the world. I have total faith in OPG's ability to get the job done. As I said earlier, we're the largest nuclear operator in Canada and the largest CANDU owner in the world. And we have as much experience or more operating CANDUs than anyone anywhere. And we have in Darlington an ideal location for new nuclear. It's a large site, close to major transmission lines, and accessible to a major load center in Ontario. We have also nearly 8,000 trained and experienced nuclear employees with extensive knowledge, strong skill sets, and proven leadership capabilities. And we have broad capability and excellence in nuclear support services. This includes engineering, health physics, nuclear waste management, and training. Our extensive network of training programs and facilities ensures our people are well-versed in the latest industry best practices. We also have a large inventory of heavy water, which is an asset we will deploy for the new build project. And we have spent the last several years building a strong project management culture through benchmarking and the successful execution and learning from complex projects. And we have strong support among the residents of the Durham community. And this is an invaluable asset for us going forward. I will tell you that we never take it for granted. And we know that we must earn that trust every day. Finally, and very importantly, we are the only electricity generating company in Ontario whose rates are set through an open and transparent public review process. Openness and transparency are important when building a new nuclear plant, and we're committed to that. Now, all of those factors I've just outlined, when taken together, we believe put OPG in a position to make a significant contribution to new nuclear. And we look forward to taking on the task, not just because it's good for OPG, but because in this endeavor, it benefits all stakeholders, including our industry and the many Canadian industries that gain employment and opportunities from nuclear projects. By constructing enhanced CANDUs at Darlington, we would continue to support a proven energy workhorse and the supply chain that backs that up. And this includes tens of thousands of jobs across Ontario and Canada, not to mention the economic spin-offs and benefits to the local communities. So let me make a further point. I believe we are in this together. It's not just an OPG project. This is an industry project. It's your project. We have a role to play. And especially our suppliers have a role to play. And let me just tell you this, for our suppliers, we have very high expectations. Be ready to meet them. With a successful new build project under its belt, I believe our industry can enter a new era. New build can provide a springboard. It can renew credibility and confidence, not just in our own eyes, but in the eyes of the world. And we can use this to our advantage by evolving and developing new products and services for both domestic and international markets. And many of these products and services will be based on experience with CANDU. For example, I can easily see future partnerships to market our CANDU experience in outage management or safe storage and decommissioning. I also see us leveraging our extensive training expertise as well as our expertise in nuclear support services. And by us, I mean the entire industry. And I'll have more to say on that particular topic in this afternoon's panel, so stay tuned. So, it's time to look upward and set our sights on that universe of possibilities that are out there. Yes, we have challenges. Capital costs, for example, are a huge challenge. If we want to deliver value, they need to be controlled. And they can be through solid project planning and governance, through rigorous scope control processes, sound monitoring of project execution, and the structuring of contracts to manage risk. But despite these challenges, we also have strengths. We can make our Canadian nuclear industry a real player in a whole range of areas and technologies. And I can see the industry moving beyond CANDU and developing expertise in other reactor technologies. You know, there's nothing carved in stone that says we have to base our business solely on CANDUs. So going forward, our industry can and should broaden its horizons, diversify its capabilities beyond provincial boundaries to embrace national, North American, and global markets. And many of you here are moving in that direction already. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We can't be that good abroad until we're first good at home. New build offers us that chance. So let's get started. Let's do it right. On schedule. On budget. All of us. And with that, I'll stop talking. But before I go, I do want to reiterate one thing, and it's this. Ontario has set a goal to build new nuclear units at Darlington. OPG is committed to doing its part to advance that goal. And we will only do it in a way that ensures the utmost value for Ontario residents and ratepayers, and indeed for all stakeholders who believe in the importance and efficacy of nuclear energy. We're ready. I'm looking out there. I think the industry's ready. Let the countdown proceed. Thank you.